Estimation of iodine value of fats and oils. The iodine value is a measure of the degree of unsaturation in fats and oils. The iodine number or value is defined as the number of grams of iodine consumed by 100 grams of fat. The principle behind the reaction is the addition of halogens like iodine to the double bonds present in the unsaturated fat. The iodine monochloride reagent is allowed to react with fat in the dark. The amount of iodine consumed is then determined by titrating the iodine released on adding potassium iodide with standardized sodium thiosulfate solution and comparing it against the contents in the iodination flask labeled blank. Materials required: iodine monochloride reagent, potassium iodide, 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate, starch indicator solution, iodination flask, chloroform, fat sample in chloroform, burette and burette stand, glass pipette, measuring cylinder, and distilled water. Procedure: arrange all the required materials on the table. Pipette out 10 ml fat sample from a 2% fat solution prepared in chloroform into an iodination flask labeled test. Stopper the flask. Pipette out 20 ml iodine monochloride reagent into the flask labeled test. Stopper the iodination flask. Swirl the flask to mix the contents. This flask is then kept in the dark for incubation at room temperature for 30 minutes. Meanwhile, prepare the blank sample by pipetting out 10 ml chloroform in an iodination flask labeled blank. Pipette out 20 ml iodine monochloride reagent to the flask labeled blank. Stopper the iodination flask. Swirl the flask to mix the contents. The flask labeled blank is then kept in dark for incubation at room temperature for 30 minutes. Take out the flask labeled test after 30 minutes incubation. Pipette out 10 ml potassium iodide solution into the flask labeled test. Stopper the flask and gently swirl it to mix the contents well. On mixing, the color of the solution in the iodination flask changes to dark red-brown. Rinse the stopper of the flask with 30 ml distilled water and mix the contents again. The contents of the flask labeled test is then titrated against 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate. Continue the titration till the solution turns pale straw color. Now close the stop cork of the burette, add 1 ml of starch solution into the flask. The color of the solution in the flask changes to purple blue. Titration is continued until the color of the solution in the flask turns colorless. The disappearance of the blue color is recorded as the end point of titration. The procedure is repeated for the flask labeled blank. Pipette out 10 ml potassium iodide solution into the blank after 30 minutes incubation. Stopper the flask and swirl it to mix the contents well. On mixing, the color of the solution in the iodination flask changes to dark red-brown. Rinse the stopper of the flask with 30 ml distilled water and mix the contents again. The contents of the flask labeled blank are then titrated against 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate. Continue the titration till the solution turns to pale straw color. Now close the stop cork of the burette, add 1 ml of starch solution into the flask. The color of the solution in the flask changes to purple-blue. Titration is continued until the color of the solution in the flask turns colorless. The disappearance of the blue color is recorded as the end point of the titration. The volume of the sodium thiosulfate used is obtained from the titer value, that is blank minus test. The iodine value can be calculated using the formula. Where equivalent weight of iodine is 127 and normality of sodium thiosulfate is 0.1. Precautions: Iodine monochloride is caustic, so handle the reagent with gloves. For better results, perform the experiments without any time gap during the titration, as the liberated iodine is susceptible to oxidation by light.